Under the boardwalk.
That's the rat hole.
Whatever. Hey everybody, I'm Michelle Carr.
And I'm Matt Carr.
This is Riding in Cars with Cars, and we are the Carr Group with Redline Real Estate. Mm-hmm. This show is all about connecting you with the amazing people that we have right here in Airdrie. Matt, who we have to pick up today?
Well, today we've got David Bowman from David Bowman Painting.
Brilliant business name.
Brilliant branding. And that way he remembers it as well.
Exactly.
But David's one of those guys that he's so unassuming. Mm-hmm. He just shows up to places. The stuff he does, like, you've known David since you were a kid.
Yeah.
And I've known David for about 12 years. I had no idea he did what he actually does.
Yeah.
And it's really quite incredible. We're lucky to have him here in Airdrie.
Yeah,
for sure.
He's a huge contributor to our community. So can't wait to find out more about what he does.
Absolutely. David Bowman from David Bowman Painting. Welcome to the car.
Happy to be here.
We're really excited to have you and learn a little bit more about you. So, David, the first question, I'm known for the hard-hitting questions.
Okay.
So my first question for you is, how did you come up with the name David Bowman Painting?
It seemed out there, but I thought I would I thought I would stretch the imagination a
right.
bit and just go for both the first and last name in the company name.
Was there any trademarking issues that you had to go through?
No, there seemed to be no other David Bowman Painting
in Alberta. So, well, again, I for the creativity of it, I just wanted to give you an A+.
However, there is a Mike Bowman Painting now.
There is.
So, and yeah, I heard about him.
But yeah, he's.
What do you think of him?
Well, he's coming along. He's getting there.
Mike is, of course, your son.
Yes, he's my youngest son.
Yeah.
And actually, all three of my sons work for me. All three of my sons are painters. They don't work for me. Jeremy, my oldest son, works for me full time, and then Mike has his own company. And John, he's a supervisor for a big company in Calgary called Zoom Painting.
Oh, okay.
Oh, wow.
So they're all doing great.
And I have to say, you are a hell of a painter.
Oh,
you're
thank you.
Quick, and you are precise. And usually, you don't get both, and you certainly do. I remember. I had a condo listed. It was actually a condo I had lived in, and then the person that bought it from me listed it to sell it. She had had someone come in and paint. The colors were not what she had selected. It was a gong show. And before we listed it, she opted to have it painted. And you came in, probably 8 in the morning, met you there, unlocked the door, and you called me at lunchtime. And I was expecting you to give me like an update or something like that. And you go, okay, I'm all done. Just take my supplies out to the car. And you painted the whole thing.
Yeah. And well.
It was amazing.
And you moved the furniture too.
Yeah.
I remember that. Yeah.
So David, have you ever been asked to paint something that was kind of strange or extremely difficult? Like, what's a job that stands out for you in your memory?
Jobs. I remember years and years and years ago, the city of Airdrie put out a tender to paint the water tower.
Oh,
and,
really?
And they wanted to paint it a tartan because we're Scottish heritage.
Airdrie, Scotland.
Yeah,
in Scotland.
So sister city.
Sister city, yeah. So, and I quoted it, but they never ended up doing it, and they just ended up repainting it. So, to paint a tartan was like astronomical.
Oh, of course it would be.
You would have been like Da Vinci in the Sistine Chapel.
Yeah. Yes.
You know, laying there for years trying to figure that out.
So I think we should revive that idea.
It is
and
an
I would
interesting
like to recommend
idea.
You.
Yeah,
to do
that
the
would
painting
be awesome.
My days of painting a water tower's tartan are
well, now, I have an interesting paint fact too. Oh. The Golden Gate Bridge is actually not golden.
It's not golden.
It is international orange is the actual color, which is safety red and safety yellow mixed together.
50-50?
50-50.
I did hear they never stop painting it.
They never stop painting it.
Yes.
They start from one end, go to the other. And then they go back and start again.
Have you ever opened a can of paint at a client's house and thought, oh God, this is going to be a horrible color?
Well, yeah, not a horrible color, but not what they assumed it would be. So they'll pick something that's they think is a gray, and because on the chip it looks gray, but when I get the first wall done, it's blue, or it's got a pinky hue or a purpley hue or something like that. And then most of the time I'm old school, so I can tint paints on site.
Oh. Yeah.
So I have the tinted colors in my van all the time.
Yeah.
So if it's too blue or too pink or too purpley, I can adjust it. Usually adjust it right there.
That's cool.
Yeah.
It's not many not many old guys like me left that can actually match paint on site.
So is there a painting tip that you could share with our viewers that people just don't know, but man, it would make a difference?
I've got one real quick. Hire a painter.
Hire a painter.
Hire a painter. Because everybody thinks it's easy to paint. It is not easy to paint.
That is true.
It is a skill.
If you're not a painter, masking tape is your friend. And but, you know, the YouTube videos are out there. Painters all have different, slightly different techniques or methods. And you just choose which method looks right for you.
I think another good tip is don't chintz out on a brush. Spend money on a good brush.
That's not
so. Oh, crap. David, you're going to have to put your humility away. I know you don't like to talk about a lot of this stuff, but we're going to force you to, so it is what it is. So I've got a list of things that you are involved in. So we've got 100 men that give a damn. The Airdrie Angel program. You helped a family after the fires in Fort Mac. You had them come and live with you. So I'm thinking to myself one day, like how many more things can this do? And then I walk into Costco and ding, 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 and it's, hey, Matt. And there you are with the Salvation Army wearing this brilliant Christmas suit.
Yes.
And not only you said, hey, I'm running out of suckers. Can you go get me a big box of suckers? And you said, I think if someone donates, they should get something for it, kids and adults. So you on your own give out suckers. Not only do you wear that suit, and you spent money on that suit, you spend money on suckers.
The suit was worth every penny I spent on it.
So are there any other things that you would like to tell people about? Because I think it's extremely important that you, when people let others know what they're involved in, because that helps others get involved and realize, hey, I could do that type of thing as well.
Currently, the big thing I'm involved in is the 100 Men's Group, along with the rest of the team there. And we've given out over $60,000to different charities in the Airdrie area. I do a lot of painting for nonprofit organizations. Like I did work at the Airdrie Food Bank, my own church a few years ago, Airdrie Family Services.
And you all, of course, helped us out when we did the home renovation for Cadence and Addison and did all the painting for that, which was incredible.
There's a group in Airdrie called Power, which is trying to build a day shelter. And what they've, for women who are fleeing violence.
Right.
And so they've purchased this house, and it's, right now I think it's wrapped up in permits. They have to renovate it. They have to bring it up to commercial standards. So I've got my name on to take on that project, and I'm hoping to rope Mike into helping me with that one. Did you hear that, Mike?
Mark, calendar.
You're getting voluntroped. Yeah. It's not voluntold. You're getting voluntroped.
But it's an easy way for me to give back to the community, because it's what I do. It's what I know. You know, I don't know if I'm getting old and sentimental, but every time I go on Facebook or something, and there's a story about somebody. Like there's a little girl right now. I think she's terminal, and they had a thing that needed this special seat for her, and I can't remember what the name of it is. Baby seat, and I read the story, and I'm bawling by the time it's done, and I thought the only way I can stop crying is if I do something. So I got a hold of the people, and I donated some money to help buy this thing. But I think empathy creates urgency for me to do something to help. That's what moves me. And it's the same thing with the family from Fort Mac, which, by the way, were really good friends.
Well, you became good friends.
Yes,
through the process.
They were total strangers, and when we first met them, and it was a little bit nerve wracking on both our accounts because they had met us. And we hadn't met them, so they came over for a get to know. They were in our house for like 20 minutes, and then they went back to their hotel, and they called us about 5 minutes after they got back, and they said, well, we talked about it, and we'd like to take you up on your offer. So they came and they stayed with us for till the end of June, and then their daughter stayed with us all summer, and then they've been back numerous times. I've been up there one time for a play that the daughter was in. And the daughter actually just last week was down for a week visiting, and we ride motorcycles together. It's
cool.
It's great. So by putting yourself out there, you get rewards back too, like almost every time.
That's amazing. You guys have such big hearts, and this isn't you alone. Debbie, your wife, is of course a Debbie, huge part of this too. And
yeah, because I'm at work all day, so she's there with, you know, all that stuff that goes with people living in your house, you know.
Yes.
And you better get her permission too. Or she better get your permission. You like you both nothing. You got to work together.
It's worse than coming home with like a stray cat. You're coming home with humans. Yeah. You got to make sure you have
buy-in. No, Debbie's always fully on board with whatever I decide to do. Whatever I start crying about.
So you mentioned that you like to ride motorcycles.
Yes.
So you must be a Sons of Anarchy fan.
Yes, I love.
I'm a Jax fan.
I love,
the rest of the show is great.
Charlie Hoonan, he's awesome.
Yeah.
But yeah, I thought that show was fantastic. Not that I'm a gangster. But,
you don't advocate for the activity.
You're just in a gangster rap. Yeah. That's all you do.
My friend from Fort Mac, however, he is in a motorcycle
club.
So it's an MC, but it's the Apostles. It's a Christian bike group.
Yeah.
So
oh, neat.
Little bit different than the Sons of Anarchy.
Yeah. David, what's the best piece of advice you've ever been given?
I guess my dad would always say, like, don't stress out about stuff. You know, there's always another day. And he had this saying, and he said, you do what you can and you throw rocks at the rest. And he was kind of a blunt guy, but what he meant by that was just like, you do the best you can, and that's the best you can do. And that's where you leave it.
What is the show that you look forward to tuning into every week right now?
Veep. It's the last season for Veep, and I love Julia Louis Dreyfus. Yeah. She plays just this horrible character. she's just the worst human being ever. But I really like the show. It's a parody of American politics. Yeah. Everybody in it is made look like a cheat, a moron, or a scumbag of some kind. And
anybody who's not a documentary.
Almost could be a documentary. Yeah.
Anybody who's really gotten into it tells us how great it is. We've just never gotten into it.
Yeah, it's on the list.
David, I have to tell this one story. And again, you're going to have to remove your humility. But I was at the 100 Men That Give a Damn. I think it was the very first one. And at the time, we were trying to increase the Angel program from 18 episodes to 24. And you said, what do you need? And I said, well, what we need right now is we need 4 more people to step up as Cloud9 sponsors, which is $1,500 a year as a sponsor. And you go, well, you got one, you need 3 more. And Dara, I don't want to cry. So when you said that, that meant so much to me. And that's when I really started to get to know who you were and really started paying attention. So from the city of Airdrie, I want to thank you because you've told us a little bit about what you've done, what you're doing, and I know there's so much more that we haven't probably scratched the surface. So I think you're an incredible man. Can't thank you enough for the support you give the Airdrie Angel program, because there's even more stories Michelle and I could tell about checks that just show up and e-transfers that just show up. you're an incredible guy. So, but we know you also fund yourself through your business. So that's important to us that you tell people how to get a hold of you if they want to have some painting done commercially or at home. How do they get a hold of you?
Well, if you Google me, you can find me, but it's 403-771-5795 is my phone number. And my email address is fairly easy to remember. It's paintman@tellusplanet.net.
Yeah.
And but speaking of things coming back, after I donated that angel the first time, within a week I got a call from somebody who heard about it, who hired me because of the donation.
Oh, wow.
That's awesome! So, that's great for us here too.
Yeah.
It's like everything always leads back.
So. Yeah.
Oh, that's great. Well, thanks so much, David. It was awesome to have you in the car.
Absolutely.
And you're a great person in our city, and we just really appreciate that you and Debbie are here.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
Okay. Sorry.
Yeah, you're a backseat driver, but a backseat interviewer.
I'll do the whole exact. Yeah, the whole time she's a backseat interviewer.